This video is about the Delhi Master Plan 2041 or 2041. Master plans are created as a vision for the future. They decide how all the policies, all the local body policies, all the state government policies, and every other policy with respect to the urban space, with respect to the city, with respect to the environment, with respect to economy, all related to land, are decided, and they set the path for the future. Now, the Delhi Development Authority, which is the Government of India agency, which looks into the land in Delhi. Now, that has come up with the Master Plan for Delhi 2041, and this master plan is now open for public consultation. So, all of you can go to the DDA website. The link is in the description below. Read the MPD 2041 or the Master Plan for Delhi 2041. And you know, whatever you think needs some kind of a consultation, you think there is a certain point that you want to give a suggestion on, you are most welcome to write to DDA. Now, what does this master plan, you know, particularly talk about? So this master plan talks about some key areas which have to be brought into focus. Now, one of the main things in this master plan is this blue green or green blue infrastructure, you know, which is to look at water bodies. Now, Delhi is crunched on water. You know, we are dependent on other states for water. So if we develop this green blue infrastructure around water bodies, we can have, you know, better groundwater retention in Delhi. And, you know, Delhi can aim for, you know, some point in the future, some kind of self-sustainable water demands that are being met by the Delhi land itself. Apart from that, you know, now Yamuna has been stressed a lot in this particular master plan. There are plans to make, you know, 300 meter wide green corridor along Yamuna River. You know, a lot of dust management policies have been put up at construction sites. You know, there is also talk about, you know, having public waterfronts, you know, in heritage areas, other areas, so that, you know, waterfronts can be developed and people can enjoy the beauty of waterfronts, which are currently in a not a good shape. You know, waterfronts have to be made into tourist spaces. Waterfronts have to be made into public spaces which the city dwellers can use. Now, there is also talk about, you know, having nice horticulture, nice landscape development along the drains, along the all the drains which are currently either not covered or, you know, are very unkempt. Another point is, you know, there is some kind of a survey of the trees. All the trees will be counted and there will be a directory and, you know, a mapping of which trees where. So this is a very good point. With respect to housing, now since we are architects, since you are very much interested in, you know, building development, housing development, housing in Delhi is a very, very, very political. It's a very, 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 very complicated scenario, because a lot of unauthorized colonies have recently been given some kind of a clearance that they are okay. You know, unauthorized colonies, the plan that there will be redevelopment of these unauthorized colonies. Now, they had come up with some kind of a Mumbai model where, you know, these areas which are unauthorized colonies, they can be made into, you know, multi-story, and certain other proposals were put forward. Now, the point is that this will have a little political tone, because there are, you know, multiple stakeholders in Delhi. We have the Delhi government, then we have the central government. Now, you know, this is a very, very critical point for the vote bank politics in Delhi. So this is one point that can be looked at academic, from the academic point of view, but also can be looked from the political point of view. So you please go through the master plan, and, you know, our master plan has certain focus on not making mixed use eligible for, has some focus of not having, you know, regularization of mixed use in residential areas. So, you know, earlier the Delhi government had allowed, that means the master plan had allowed that people who are doing, you know, smaller works, like, for example, PCO, you have a boutique, you have stationery shop, you have vegetable seller, all these things were allowed under mixed use in residential colonies. But this particular master plan 2041 says no more, you know, residential roads in Delhi would be converted into mixed use land. So that means this master plan kind of gives certain, put certain brake on further commercialization of residential areas. Now that can be a very, very good step. But on the other hand, there was a ceiling drive and people lost employment in Delhi. You know, a lot of places where people were running big markets, big shops, all these places were sealed, and there was a promise that the government is going to regularize them or give them some kind of a provision so that they can keep doing business there. Apart from that, there is a big, you know, focus on the rental housing. Now, the government has recently, you know, proposed rental housing, that instead of giving ownership-based housing for the poor or the people in the lower strata of the society in Delhi, they would, you know, make large developments into rental housing developments, which means that these places will be owned by the developer, but people who live there will keep paying rent to the developer. Now, this is a different scheme. There is a link in the description of what this scheme means and what is this rental thing all about. That's a separate topic which requires further discussion. Apart from that, a redevelopment of authorized colonies, as mentioned before, will follow a certain, you know, criteria, which is good for the people, because eventually that will mean a lot of wider space for them, all the civic facilities, civic utilities. But on the other hand, this can be a little political issue, because people whose colonies are regularized tend to become vote bank for certain political parties, this side or that side, whichever way. But this has to be taken in a very, very balanced manner, so that there is political survival and that there is also, you know, good of the city in the long run. Apart from that, a lot of cultural hotspots will be developed in Delhi, like in the walled city area, Mehroli, CP, and Shah Jahanabad or the old Delhi will be converted into a cultural hub, and there will be creation of public spaces. Development of business promotion districts from the economic point of view will be there. And, you know, 24-hour city will be promoted. That means a nightlife in the city will be officially created. And new industrial areas will be created as hubs of this clean economy. Now, when I say new industrial areas, the previous industrial areas, you know, they have been allowed to do commercial activities fully. When I say commercial activities, non-industrial commercial activities have been allowed in this particular master plan. Now, these were some points, important points of this master plan. Now, we also, with respect to transport, you know, there has been creation of fast roads. There has been, you know, push for cycling and walkable streets in the city. There has been other proposals which have been put forward. The whole idea here is that this is the future vision, and we are all part of Delhi. So everybody is entitled equally to, you know, give their comments on this Delhi Master Plan 2041. So please go through this copy and provide your comments to the Delhi Development Authority. Thank you very much.